Who could be calling us so early in the morning?
Hello?
Who?
Long distance? Who? Brooklyn calling. Hey, Peg, Brooklyn is calling.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, this is Chester A. Riley. Hello? Hello? Hello, Mom?
Mom?
How are you, Mom? Yeah, we're fine. Are you all right? Yeah, I'm all right. How is Pop all right? Yeah, Peg's all right.
Give her my love.
Mom, Peg sends you her love. Mom sends you her love.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah. What's new? Oh, that's too bad. You don't say. It's raining in Brooklyn. That's my insanity. Huh? No, it ain't raining here in California. Hey, Mom, why did you call me long distance? It's so expensive. What? Yeah, yeah, that's right, Mom. Hey, yeah, yeah. Imagine, it's my birthday. Mom called me up. She remembered it was my birthday.
After all, she had a little to do with it.
Yeah. After all, you had a little to do with it. Ha, ha, ha. Ha, ha, ha. Yeah. Hey, Mom. Mom, you there? Mom, listen, give our love to everybody. Yeah. Huh? I don't know. Oh, I owe you a letter. Oh, yeah, yeah. Okay, Mom. Well, I'll write you as soon as I hang up. Okay. Thanks a lot, Mom, for calling. Goodbye, sweetheart. Here's a kiss. Goodbye, Mom. Gee,
I miss my mom. You know, it's a funny thing, but every time I have a birthday, I realize that Mom's getting a year old.
Oh, darling. Well, happy birthday for you from me.
Oh, Pink, you shouldn't have done it.
Oh, handkerchiefs, Peg. Just what I need.
You like them? They're the extra large size, you know.
Yeah, perfect for my nose.
Happy birthday, Daddy. Here's a little something for you.
Gee, Babs, you shouldn't have done it. Now, let's see what you did. Boy, wooden shoes. Just what I needed.
Oh, Daddy, they're not wooden shoes. They're shoe trees. You put them in your shoes.
Then how do I get my feet in? Oh, shoe trees! Yeah. I'm so excited, I don't know what I'm talking about.
Hi, everybody.
Oh, hi, Pop. Junior, you shouldn't have done it. Do you know what today is today?
Sure I do, and I'm on my way to buy it for you right now.
Oh, Junior, could you give me a little hint as to what it is?
Well, you know, Pop. Rat poison.
Rat poison?
Sure. You told me to be sure and get rat poison Saturday, because you need it for the cellar. Be right back.
Wait for me out on the porch, Junior. I'll get dressed and go with you.
Okay, Pop.
Fine thing. My birthday. My son's buying a present for a rat. Working slave. And what do you get in the end?
Oh, cheer up, Mr. Riley. What if your son didn't give you a present today?
You don't understand, Waldo. This thing goes deeper than just under the surface. Show me where a boy forgets his father, and I'll show you a father who hasn't got the brains to raise his kids right.
Now, we must be tolerant of the younger generation.
The younger generation. No respect for their fathers. Take me and my father. I looked up to the old walrus. But that Junior, he's an ingrate.
Oh, don't call him an ingrate. Oh, he's a fine lad. Many's the time I wish Mrs. Benny and I had had a son instead of a cocker spaniel.
Junior's an ingrate, that's what he is.
Telephone, Mr. Riley.
I'll get it.
It's not for me. It's probably Junior's girlfriend, Marilyn, calling him up. She's always gabbing with him.
Hello?
A boy of 13. Does he think about his father? All he's got on his mind is love.
I'm swell, Marilyn. How are you, Goof?
Oh, Goof. Does he ever call me Goof? Tell you, that Marilyn's a bad influence on him.
Oh, my pop's fine, thanks. How's your old man?
Hey, she was asking after me. That Marilyn's a swell kid.
No, I don't know what to get him. Well, I saw a bathrobe at Jerry Rothschild. It was super.
Waldo, I was wrong. He remembered. He remembered.
Oh, how nice. And you were disturbed.
Yes.
Yeah, but it cost $12.63 with tax.
My boy is getting me a bathrobe. Isn't he a swell, Andre?
Marilyn, who's got that kind of dough? Okay. Goodbye.
Too bad, Mr. Riley. I guess you're not getting the robe after all.
Who ain't? All he needs is the money, right?
Right.
Well, it's for a good cause. Me, ain't it?
Yes.
Okay. I'm gonna give him the money so he thinks he found it by accident.
Oh, fine. What an extremely ingenious idea.
Now, let's see.
Golly, look at all the dough in here.
You
know? Well, I declare, how much?
Let's see. There's 10, 11, 12, 15... $12.62. 63 cents. Yeah, here's another penny.
Well, what an odd amount. Is it yours, Riley?
No, it's not mine. Anyway, finders is keepers. Bob, it must be yours. It's your tobacco jar. Here, take it.
Junior, I'm ashamed of you trying to cheat me into money that ain't mine. It ain't mine.
It isn't. Is it yours, Beth?
Me with $12? Jeepers.
Junior, is it yours?
Gosh, no. I wish it was.
Riley, are you sure you didn't put that money in the jar?
I'm positive it's not mine.
Oh, well, then I must have. I can certainly use this for the house. Well, I'm going to the library. It's almost two.
Gee. $12. Why can't I have luck to find that kind of dough?
You found it, didn't you? The trouble with you is you wouldn't know what to do with money if you did have any.
Boy, I know what to do, all right.
Don't tell me. I ain't interested. I got other things on my head.
Boy, if I had that kind of dough, I'd...
I said don't tell me. Now do what I tell you and don't tell me.
First thing I'd do would be to...
Please, don't tell me, Jim.
Okay, Pop.
Yoo-hoo, Mr. Riley.
Hey, Waldo, come here. What do you think happened? My wife wound up with the dough.
Oh, that's tragic.
Yeah, but I got another idea. I got a great idea this time.
Oh, good. Where do we hide the money this time?
We ain't hiding the money. I'm gonna give them the money direct. Without any middleman mixing in like my wife. Junior!
Yeah, Pop?
Come in here a minute, Sonny. Boy, what a brainstorm this is. I'm as good as taking a bath in that bathrobe right now.
Well, what's up, Pop? Hi, Mr. Benny.
Junior?
Junior, I'd like to talk to you. Would you sit down, please?
What did I do?
You didn't do nothing. Just sit down.
Well, I am sitting down.
Oh. Junior, I'm working on a plan to make things... Well, operate a little smoother around here.
Huh?
Well, you know I'm a busy man, and, you know that.
No, I guess so.
Well, I am. Just because I lay around here every night, and all day Saturdays and Sundays, that don't mean that I ain't busy. My time's worth money.
Okay, if you say so.
Well, I do say so. I say it's worth about, $10 an hour.
Then how come your boss only pays you $1.50 an hour?
Well, that's because I don't do any thinking for him. All I do for him is work.
Oh.
Now, I gotta save all my valuable time for the big things and cut out all the petty details. Now, about your allowance.
Oh, Pop, you're cutting out my allowance.
No, I ain't. Well, the way things are working out now, your allowance is taking up a lot of my valuable time.
It is?
Well, sure, just figure it out for yourself. Now, I come home from work on payday. I stick my head through the door, and the first thing you do is ask me for your allowance.
Yeah, but you don't give it to me.
Right, but I get sore at you because I think that that's the only thing you got in your mind, and I boil you out. Now, how long does that take?
Well, sometimes you yell at me for an hour.
Well, that's $10 of my valuable time shot.
Junior, do you follow this?
No.
Neither do I.
Well, it's very simple, Waldo. Every time I give Junior his 50 cents allowance, it costs me $10.
What do you want me to do, Pop?
Junior, you got to help me out of a jam.
Sure.
You got to take 6 months' allowance in advance.
6 months in advance?
Yeah.
Let's see. Four each in a month times six, 24. That's $12.
Yeah. You better take 26 weeks in advance. That's $13.
Yes. Oh, yes. Oh, that's a fine idea.
Well, what do you say?
Gee, I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know? Why not?
Golly, if I got all that much money at once, it'd go too fast.
Well, let it go, as long as it goes in the right direction.
Oh, it's a fine idea, Junior.
Well, what do you say, Junior? Will you take the $13 worth of allowance in advance?
Okay.
Good.
Atta boy, son. Waldo, lend me $13. It worked, Waldo. It worked like a charm, Waldo.
But what if the boy catches us with this? It isn't cricket.
Don't worry, he won't catch us. There it is, Jerry Rothschild's men's shopping.
I bet it's a bathrobe.
Oh, he shouldn't have done it. Now, let's make sure that he did.
Oh, I'm so keyed up. Oh, boy. A blue one with red figures.
He remembered me, Waldo, and out of a clear sky.
You better put it back in the box before you get caught snooping.
No, I'm going to try it on. I want to see if I look as good in it as it did on that dummy in the window. Boy, oh, boy. Well, how do I look in my boy's present? What a wonderful feeling.
Oh, Mr. Riley, I heard something. Put it back in the box.
No, I want to grovel in it.
Junior! Junior, are you... Oh, it's you, Mr. Riley.
Hello, Marilyn. Waldo, this is Junior's girlfriend, Marilyn.
Junior's fiancé.
Yeah, Junior's fiancé. Marilyn, I'm sorry, but Junior ain't here.
Well, that's too bad. Oh, Mr. Riley, what are you doing wearing my father's robe?
Well, what Junior don't know. What do you mean, your father's robe?
Why, yes. Didn't Junior tell you?
No. I don't believe it. Junior got me this robe for my birthday.
Happy birthday. Mr. Riley, I'm awfully sorry, but it's for my father. It's his birthday tomorrow. May I have it, please?
Yeah. Sorry that I tried it on. Here you are.
Thank you. Bye.
Don't take it so hard, Mr. Riley. After all, the younger generation.
After all I've done for that boy, this is how he repays me. I made a lot of sacrifices for him, Waldo. And this is the gratitude he shows me. Buying gifts for Marilyn's father with my money.
My money? It must be a bitter blow to you that he thinks so much of this Mr. Morris.
That Morris. He's a windbag. He's a overstuffed, stuffed shirt. He's obnoxious and... Gee, I wish I was him.
Oh, it's a very nice robe, Marilyn.
Junior picked it out for me, Mother. Oh. I gave him the money.
But your daddy can't possibly use two robes, dear.
But, Seabrook, I didn't know Brother was sending him one from college. Now what'll I do for a gift?
I know. You give Daddy one of the presents I got for him. I got two. Pipe, the pipe ring. And you return the robe to,
Jerry Rothschild.
Fine.
I've a better idea. I'm afraid Junior isn't going to get anything for his father's birthday. I know he was broke this morning.
Oh, that's too bad.
Why don't I send this to Mr. Riley and let him think it's from Junior?
Oh, dear. That is a sweet idea.
Coming. Got a package for a character named Riley.
Sign here, please. Wait a minute. I got to see what's in it first. A robe. From Junior. He bought one for me, too.
Sign here, please.
Gee, I feel swell. Here, fella. Here's a dime for you.
A dime?
Sorry, I couldn't take it.
Income tax bracket.
Besides, Mrs. Morris already paid the charges.
Sign here, please.
Mrs. Morris. Then this must be the robe that Junior bought Marilyn's father. And they sent it back to me. I get it. They feel sorry for me.
Naturally. Man your age who can't sign his name.
They took pity on me because Junior forgot me.
Okay, don't sign. I'll mark an X here and say it was you.
Well, they're not getting away with it. I'll take care of that, Morris. I don't need any secondhand leftover presents for my birthday.
O'Reilly.
Mr. Morris, take back your cheesy bathrobe.
Mother, I got it.
Oh, fine, fine.
Oh, it's a lovely robe. Blue with red figures. Mr. Rothschild said they're very popular lately.
Oh.
He sold three today.
That's grand. I've got the card made out to Pop from Junior. This is beautiful. Imagine that boy forgetting your father's birthday.
Well, I'll just lay it right here on the chair, hmm?
All right. Oh, he loved me. You know, he was really very upset about this. But he's so sentimental, I bet he'll go crazy when he sees it.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. Looks like it is. That's Morris. Now he's breaking into my house to make me take this robe. Fix him.
Again. Now listen, I'm getting sick and tired.
You're getting tired. It's me that's doing the walking. I'm telling you for the last time, keep your bathroom.
Hey, Dick. O'Reilly.
Yeah, look, you're an undertaker. If that Morris don't stop hounding me, he's going to wind up in your lap.
What's perturbing you, mate, me?
Oh, it's a long story. You see, today is my birthday, and I
just... Oh, I knew that. I was just on my way to your house to congratulate you. Congratulations.
You remembered, Digger.
But of course. I know everybody's birthday, and each year I remember them. Someday they'll remember me.
My wife and daughter remember this, not my son.
Oh, well, the day isn't over yet.
It is for me, Digger. It's not the gift, but what will my friends say when they find out that Junior has no maternal love for his father?
Now, now, stop hanging crepe and listen to an expert. Your friends need never know. Buy a gift yourself and pretend it came from your son.
I think that's a great idea.
Besides, it'll shame the lad. Teach him a lesson.
Oh, gee, Digger, you put new life into me.
I did. Well, let's keep it between ourselves, shall we?
Thanks a lot. I gotta go. Wait a minute, I can't buy the robe. It's $12.63 and I'm broke.
Oh, no, you're not.
Oh, Digger, I couldn't.
Oh, now, now, you're not the first friend I've carried. Here. Here's $13.
Gee. Thanks, Digger. I'm sure glad you came along.
Mm. Nice chap, Riley, but so depressing.
Well, Dumplin, how do I look in my swell robes that my boy Junior got me?
Oh, you look wonderful, dear.
Oh, it's just so lovely, Daddy. Real chic.
Boy, I wish Junior was here to see me in it. I think I'll go in the dining room and take another gander in that mirror.
Oh, Baz, I'm so glad we got in that robe.
Yes, but we'll have to tell Junior not to let on it wasn't from him.
You know, I guess a lot of people thought that my Junior wouldn't remember my birthday, but... Oh, by the way, Peg, when he gets here, I want to talk to him private. Right away, before anybody else does.
Yoo-hoo, Mr. Ivy.
Waldo, you're just in time to see my terrific birthday present.
Oh, wonderful, wonderful. I see you got your present from, Junior.
Who else?
Well, how did you know that, Mr. Binney?
Oh, a little bird told me.
Hi, Pop.
Oh, Junior.
Sorry I'm late, but I finally got it. Where did you get that?
What's the matter with you, Junior? Is your memory failing you? Don't you remember? You bought it for me.
I bought it? No.
Junior, I think we'd better go to my room. I got something to tell you.
But I didn't.
Don't argue with him. You sent him that robe.
Yes, Junior. Don't be such a dope.
But I did, Junior. You come outside with me, and I'll prove you sent your father the robe. Somebody's crazy. I got Papa a gift, okay, but I got it right here.
Huh?
In this box, a bathrobe. Tried to get your bowling ball, but I couldn't find any left in town. I went everywhere. So I went back and got this robe.
Not the robe. Thank you, Junior.
Where did you get this one, the one you got on?
Never mind that. Just as long as you remember, that's all I care about.
I get it. You bought that robe. You thought I wasn't going to remember. Oh, Pop.
Well, I...
Gee, Pop, you must think I'm a pretty funny kind of a son.
It wasn't your father, Junior. It was my fault. I was the one that thought you wouldn't remember.
Well, I put Mother up to it.
Now, wait a minute, Babs. Junior, it's my fault. I bought this robe.
Oh, Riley, no, you mustn't take the blame. I bought it.
Wait a minute, folks. Your family trusted you, Junior. I was the doubting Thomas. I bought the robe.
Somebody's nuts.
Wait a minute. Everybody's nuts. I went down to Jerry Rothschild's and bought this robe myself.
I phoned him for it.
I gave Babs the money for it.
And I brought it home. I did. Yes, yes, I
did. Hold it. Wait a minute. Quiet. I ought to know where I got it.
Goodness, what's going on?
Now, wait a minute, Marilyn. Don't you get into this. The first thing you know, you'll be telling me that you sent me this robe.
Why, yes, Mr. Wright. But how did you find out?
This is ridiculous. We couldn't all have sent him that robe. Anybody can see
well,
that.
Well, that's right. Of course.
Wait a minute. Just a second. Hold it. Will you hold it? Now, wait a second. There's only two robes. Two. The one that I bought and the one that Junior bought. Two robes. Do you get it? Two robes.
Where's that injured rider?
Now, you wait a minute. Here. Wait a minute. Marvin.
Here.
Wait.
And stop hounding me. Come on, Marilyn.
Now I got five bathrobes. Just what I needed.
Happy bathrobe.